Dear all, welcome to this new tutorial. Let's discover Autodesk SketchBook, a free and complete tool to realize amazing sketches and drawings. SketchBook collects loads of freehand and guides tools to realize all drawings and animations without any paid license, available for both Windows and Mac OS desktop and smartphone devices. Despite we are going to use a desktop version, its main features don't differ much as its mobile app. It is also suggested in case you prefer drawing with digital pens. When opening SketchBook, a blank canvas opens with a standard size. You can enable the crop tool and click and drag over it to resize it. Once you click on Apply Above. In addition, you can go to Image, Canvas Size, to make precise adjustments. The general interface is very handy. You have the main toolbar above with all the tools and features available, the paintbrush palette on the left with all the main drawing tools, and the lagoon wheel at the bottom that collects the same tools of the toolbar. This is optimized for pens, since you can select any tool by simply clicking and dragging from any button. In the same way, you can right-click and drag. You can close any palette with the red button. You can reopen these from the Window tab. To start drawing, enable any tool from either the brush palette or the lagoon. These are freehand tools that you can use by clicking and dragging on the canvas. Each brush tool has its own style, going from the simple pencil-like brush to an airbrush, a marker, a ballpoint pen, or a paintbrush. However, the brush palette is only a small group of all the brushes available. You can open the brush library to find the right one you are looking for, including shapes, splatters, and pastels. You can undo any action with Control or Command and Z, or the red-green arrows to undo and redo any time. Whereas hold down the spacebar key to enable several visualization buttons to zoom in and out, rotate, and move around the canvas. To adjust your brush, you can click and drag vertically and horizontally over the two pucks. The white one is called brush puck and sets either the brush size or the brush flow and opacity. The black one is the color puck and fixes the brush color. Click once on it to set the color brightness, saturation, and hue, enabling the eyedropper to pick the color from the canvas directly. At this point, you can drag from the puck to adjust the brightness or the saturation level for the current color. You can also open the color editor to adjust the color precisely, or select the randomize feature to randomize colors within a defined hue range. From the brush palette, you can also enable the smear, the blur, and the sharpen tools to refine your brushes by adjusting shape, adding blurriness, or increasing details by clicking and dragging over these. On the other hand, you can use the eraser tools to cancel your drawings by brushing over these with either a hard or a soft level. Adjust eraser size and hardness from the brush puck. Inside SketchBook, you can get several drawing aids over your canvas. Click on Ruler to drop a straight line that you can rotate, stretch, and move with its nodes. Check the measurements at the bottom, and click and drag over it to draw along its line. This way, you can drop several straight lines as you need. Click on the cross to hide the ruler. In the same way, you can drop an ellipse or a French curve to use as a guideline. Enable perspective guides to make outstanding perspective drawings. Just select the number of points and place these as you need on the canvas. Then, make your drawing. The same cursor helps you at locating the axis as you move. On top, enable and disable snappings to these axes. Lock the points or hide the perspective axis. Use symmetry to draw on both sides of a single central axis, or more of them as you like. You can use these in combination with other drawing aids just seen. SketchBook includes several drawing tools, like Steady Stroke and Predictive Stroke. With the first one, you brush after a certain distance. With the second one, you can adjust your freehand drawing in order to make curves much smoother. Whereas with Draw Style, you can draw straight segments, rectangles, circles, and polygons by clicking and dragging on the canvas. In this case, you can also apply the Flood Fill tool by simply clicking within their area. This also works within any enclosed freehand drawing and can be used to fill an entire canvas background. On top, select between a solid and uniform fill and a linear or radial gradient. These show nodes that you can move and change in color from the color puck. From its palettes, you can apply great ready-made gradients to start from. You can also click on the dash line to add more nodes and use the cross button to remove any. SketchBook includes several selection tools used to limit your drawing area without impacting other sides of the canvas. Enable Select and choose the tool in order to drop any rectangle, ellipse, or freehand shape with Lasso and Polyline. Use Magic Wand to perform a precise selection with one click instead. You can also combine multiple areas together using Add to unify regions, Remove to subtract them, and Invert to invert the region. Use Deselect to remove any selection. All the drawings and objects on the canvas are managed as layers. Click on Layers to open the Layer Editor palette, showing all the layers present. By default, you have Layer 1, representing your drawing and background for the canvas background. You can create more layers with the plus button above. At this point, select the interested layer to start drawing on it. Use the I button to hide and show each layer. If you hide the background, the canvas will be a checkered area, indicating full transparency. Moreover, you can click and drag from the double arrow to change the layer's order, especially in case you get elements overlapped. Drag over the right blue bar to adjust the opacity level of each layer, and click on the lock button to block any possible drawing over it until you unlock it. To rename, remove, or duplicate any layer, just click and drag from it. Besides simple drawings, you can also work with pieces of text and images. Go to Add Text Layer to add annotations by defining content, font, size, style, and color. Then you can move, rotate, scale, and also distort it directly. The piece of text has its own independent layer, so make sure not to have it selected, or you won't be able to draw at all. You can also import images with File, Add Image, moving and editing it if you need. Also, these images have their own independent layer, with the difference that you can draw inside and adjust the image appearance. You can also go to Image, Adjust to make corrections on brightness, contrast, hue, saturation, and color balance. SketchBook also includes advanced transform tools. Select the correct layer and enable Quick Transform to move, scale, rotate, and distort it. You can also enable any selection tool to move and extract parts of the current layer from it. Pay attention that this action is permanent. The Transform tool is very similar, but uses nodes around the layer borders. You can switch to Distort to change its perspective. Very good for 3D-like drawings. Now let's see how to save and export your drawings. Go to File, Save As, to save your document in several formats. Choose TIFF if you want to reopen your work and save all its layers and structure, and JPEG or PNG to rasterize all layers in an image, with PNG saving any transparency present. With SketchBook, you can also open a flipbook to realize animations going from one canvas to another at a defined size between 720p and 1080p, and number of frames per second. Just like video frames, you can draw on the canvas frame per frame in order to realize a complete animation. You can use all the drawing and editing features seen, with the difference that you can fill up to 4 layers, including the canvas background. You can save these animations as a .skba files, if you want to edit these anytime. Or go to File, Export Flipbook to export your animation as a video or a .gif file. Thank you very much for watching this tutorial. Do not lose our next free guides and giveaways by subscribing and supporting us.